Welcome to lesson 7. So last class we learned how to use a function to group logic together such that we can repeat it by calling the function. Today we're going to learn how to use parameters, which will allow us to pass values into our functions. Here is a real life example of how a parameter is used. If you've been to McDonald's, you've probably seen this kiosk machine where you're allowed to customize your meal. You can pick how many slices of cheese you want, how many sausages, and etc. So the recipe to create the hamburger will stay the same. The only thing we're doing here is changing the quantity of the ingredients. So in terms of code, the function stays the same. The only difference here is we're adding some customizations to it, so that way it can do something a bit different. So let's start off by creating a function to create a hamburger. Define make hamburger, and then let's add the steps. Print cook meat, print put on bun, print serve to customer. And now to use this function, all we have to do is call it outside of the function block. So we just have to hit enter and then backspace and then call make hamburger and open the parenthesis. And now if you click run, you're gonna see us as cook meat, put on bun, serve to customer. And that's how you write a function. So when we created a function, we have these parentheses here that we never talked about. So these parentheses are actually used for parameters. So what we want to do in here is provide it the parameters that we want to use. For our example, we have cheese and sausage that we want to add to our hamburger. So let's add cheese and sausage. So now we have two parameters in this function. Let's click run and see what happens. So we got an error here saying missing two required positional arguments, cheese and sausage. What this means is on line 5, when we make a call to make hamburger, we need to provide the cheese and the sausage. To fix this error, we have to pass the values for these two parameters on line 5. So you see these parentheses. Basically, the first thing we need to pass is the value for cheese, and the second is the value for sausage. So the order here matters based on the order that we created the parameters in. So in this case, cheese and then sausage. So let's give it 2 cheese and 2 sausages. And now let's run our code. So our code works normally, and we got the same output as before. So now if we want to customize our hamburger, we can use these parameters, cheese and sausage. So you can kind of think of these as variables that are scoped for this function. So it can only be used inside this function, and if you use it outside, it's not gonna work. For example, I can add line 6 and do print cheese. So now if I click run, we're gonna run into an error saying that name error, name cheese is not defined. This happens because cheese does not exist. In order for us to print cheese, we need to create a variable called cheese in the scope of this program. So we can just do cheese equals 5. And if we run this code, now we'll see 5 getting outputted. Cool. So now inside our function, we can also do print cheese and sausage. And now let's run the code. Here you see 2, 2. Because on line 6, we passed it the value 2 for cheese and 2 for sausage. So as you can imagine, we can change these values up. So now I can give it 5 sausages and 1 cheese. And now if I run the code, you're going to see 1 and 5, which is basically the cheese and sausages. So now let's actually use these values to do something useful. So we can just print add, and then we can put $0 and then cheese. And then here we can do format and then pass the cheese over. And let's do the same for the sausage. So sausage and then sausage. So now let's get rid of line 4 and now let's run our code. Now you're gonna see cook meat, put on bun, add 1 cheese and add 5 sausage and then serve to the customer. So now we can call make hamburger with different values. So let's copy make hamburger and paste it. So now maybe I want 10 cheese and 2 sausages. So now if I run this code, you're gonna see, you know, cook meat, put on bun, 1 cheese, 5 sausages, and then 10 cheese and 2 sausages. So that's how we use parameters to customize our functions. Before we end this video, I just want to show you the relationship between the parameters and the values. So as you can see here, we have our function here, and then we have one parameter here and the second parameter here. And basically, when we call the function make hamburger, this 5 maps to this cheese, and this 2 maps to this sausage. So the order in which we provide these values matter based on the order that we write it in the function. Also, if we want to add another parameter, It's very simple. All we have to do is add another parameter. So now we can even add tomatoes as a parameter. And we also have to update where we're calling our function, so that way it includes the value for tomatoes as well. So let's give it a 3, and as you can see, this 3 also maps to this tomato. Next, I want to go into more detail about the scope of a parameter versus a variable. Cool, so let's erase everything here. In the previous lesson, we talked about the importance of spacing and how spaces are used to determine the blocks of code. So for example, when you create a function, you'll have a block like this for the signature of the function. So here you'll put define, and then the name, and then the parameters. And then we would indent, and then write the block of the code that belongs to the function inside here. And basically, as we write more functions, our code will look something like this. Okay, so let's say we have 3 functions in here. So for all these functions, you notice how they all line up together. And for the actual logic of the functions, they all line up together as well. This yellow line represents the program as a whole. So basically all of our program code goes here, and then all of our function logic goes on the red line. So let's create the variable cheese. Cheese equals 1. And if we put this variable here on the yellow line, this cheese variable can be accessed by everything in the red. So it can be accessed here, here, and here. Now if we have a cheese for the parameter of this function, this cheese will take priority first. So in this code, if we use the parameter cheese, it would reference this cheese. And inside this function, if it doesn't have a parameter cheese, and we want to use cheese, it would reference this cheese out here. And basically the parameter in this function would not affect the parameter in this function or this function. So they're all kind of self-contained. In addition, any variables declared on this yellow line, which is basically the main program, can be accessed within each function. However, if we create a parameter inside a function, let's say eggs, and this is the parameter for this function, this eggs only belongs inside this function. If we try to use eggs in our main program like this, we would get an error because eggs does not exist in the scope of the main program. It only exists inside the scope of this function here. An easy way to visualize this is to draw some boxes. So for our main program, we can draw a giant box here, and this cheese belongs within the whole box. So everything within the box can have access to that cheese. And we can also draw a box for each function. So function 1, function 2, and function 3. So now you can see the scope of each block. And the parameters for each function can only be accessed within the function. And if we declare variables inside the function, they can only be accessed inside that scope. Hopefully that makes sense. If it doesn't, don't worry. We will go into more details later on in this course. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe for more content.